Welcome to this channel. In this tutorial, we will design a latch and the delay associated with the meta stability. Before going into this tutorial, I request you to like, share, and subscribe to my channel below. So, click on Components and select the PMOS with explicit substrate connection and place this on the schematic window. Now we have to mirror this PMOS, so use Ctrl E to mirror the PMOS and place this on the schematic window. Again click on Component and select the NMOS with explicit substrate. Use Ctrl E to mirror the NMOS. Now again click on Components and select PMOS with explicit substrate connection and place this on the schematic window. Click Escape and now again click on Components and select NMOS with explicit substrate connection and place this on the schematic window. Click Escape. Click on Wire. Connect the drain of PMOS to the drain of NMOS and the drain of second PMOS to the drain of second NMOS. Next, connect the gate of PMOS to the gate of NMOS and connect the second PMOS gate to the gate of NMOS. Now we must place a voltage source in the schematic. So click on Components and then select the voltage source. Place this particular voltage source on the schematic window. Next click on Ground and place this ground next to the voltage source. Now click on Wire and connect the negative terminal of the source to the ground and a wire to the positive terminal. Right click on the voltage source, change the value to 1 volt and name this particular voltage source to VDD. Click on Label Net and place the label net VDD on the wire. Click on Wire, place the wire on the source of PMOS. Similarly, place the wire on other source of PMOS. Now click on Label Net and place the label net VDD on the wire and on the substrate of PMOS. Next, click on Ground and place this ground connection to the substrate of the NMOS transistor. Now, click on Wire and connect the source of NMOS to the ground connection. Now, connect the output of CMOS 2 to the input of CMOS gate 1 and the output of CMOS gate 1 to the input of CMOS gate 2. Click on Capacitor and place two capacitors on the schematic window. Click on Ground and place this particular ground next to the capacitor. Click on Wire, connect the capacitor to the ground and the capacitor to the terminal and connect the capacitor C1 to the terminal and next the capacitor to the ground. Now we have to select the appropriate model for PMOS and for the NMOS. So right click on the PMOS and we have to define the model name, which is similar to the BSIM model file which is present. So name this as P_50N as the model name and define the length as 50 nano and the width as 1 micro. Similarly, right click on NMOS and change the model name to N_50 nano and define the length as 50 nano and the width as 500 nano. Now, next, right click on the second PMOS, define the model name as P_50N and length as 50N and width as 1 micro. Next, right click on our second NMOS and define the model name as N_50N and define the length as 50N and the width as 500 nano. Next, right click on the capacitor and define its value as 50 farad. We will define the term called as IC, which is the initial condition, which is equal to 500 milli. And click OK. Right click on capacitor 2 and define the similar value what we defined for the capacitor C1. Now click on ground and place the ground on the schematic window. Connect the source of NMOS to the ground. Now click on edit and click on spice derivative. We have to include the BSIM model. So include this particular file called as .include BSIM4_model. .text and place this on the schematic window. Now click on edit and select the spice analysis and select transient analysis and define the stop time as 4 milliseconds. Now save this particular file in the folder where we have saved the BSIM model file. So you can give a name to this schematic as flip-flop and now to make things easier, we will place the label net. So click on label net and we will define the input and the output. So define the output as Vout and place this on the output and click on label net and define Vin and place this on the wire. Right click on the transient analysis. Define the stop time as 4 nano instead of 4 milliseconds. Click on run button and place the probe on Vin and place the probe on Vout. So this particular output shows how the metastability can result in long delay before the output moves to a valid logic state. In this simulation, the two capacitors are charged to 50 millivolt, where we initially defined that particular initial condition. It takes appropriate 2.5 nanoseconds for the input and output signal to change the state. Thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope this has helped your learning purpose. I request you to like, share, and subscribe my channel below.